Happy Book Talk Tuesday. A few weeks ago, I did a book talk and I talked about a couple books, One for the Murphys and The Honest Truth. And lots of kids have been coming in asking for those books and books like that. And so I wanted to talk for a couple weeks about books that are kind of like that. And so in One for the Murphys, the girl in that book, the main character, was in foster care and she ended up with a family that was really like an amazing family. And she, when she finally realized that this could be a great place for her to, you know, to live and be, her life kind of got turned upside down again. And then in The Honest Truth, which that author is coming to our school, in The Honest Truth, the main character of that book had cancer and he was on a journey to climb a mountain that he and his grandfather were going to climb before his grandfather died. But he went to do that without telling anybody where he was going or what he was doing. He just left and he was sick. So those are great books to put yourself in someone else's shoes. That's why I love realistic fiction so much, because I can get a glimpse of someone else's life that is very different from me, and it helps me to understand other people better. When people are being real crabby or grumpy, if somebody at the grocery store is like very snappy or not very, very nice, or even at school when someone's snappy and not very nice, I think something else is going on and it is not personal. And I don't know what's happening in their life, but it's probably a lot rougher than what I'm going through. So these are some of the books I want to talk to you about today. So The Benefits of Being an Octopus is about a girl who is living, she takes care of her siblings after school while her mom works. They are living with mom's boyfriend, and if they weren't living with mom's boyfriend, they would be homeless. Mom just doesn't make enough money to support the kids, and she doesn't want to lose them, so they're living with the boyfriend, who is not a nice person. He doesn't really care about the kids. He's very restrictive with what they spend money on and what they buy. And so it's not the best place to be for the family. The girl in this book, what is her name? Zoe. She's in seventh grade, and her best friend kind of stay under the radar so nobody pays attention to him, which she compares herself to an octopus a lot, because octopi will blend in to their environments. So at school, one of her teachers forces her to be on the debate team, and which is good. She is really actually a good candidate for that. But once she gets into debate, she starts to see everything from different points of view and realizes that she is going to have to take a stand to use her voice to speak up against things that are not right in her life. And that is one of the most challenging things she will ever have to face. So it's a great book, The Benefits of Being an Octopus. Because of Mr. Terupt, so there are four books in this series now. I think the fourth one is probably the final one that will be out. We are waiting for that to come to school right now. But Because of Mr. Terupt by Rob Buyea, he's another great author. This book is about a group of kids that are in sixth or seventh grade that have this teacher that they just love. He's an amazing teacher, and he's one of those teachers that everybody wants to get. Now, he does not put up with a lot of nonsense. He just doesn't. He is serious, but he loves his students. And he knows how to deal with each one on, you know, different levels. We're all on different levels, and we all are bringing different baggage to the classroom. So, there is something that happens in this book that is pretty tragic, and the kids are going to have to come together as a class despite all their disagreements and differences and their pride and their attitude. They're going to have to put that all aside to come together to support a very important person at this school. It's really, y'all, a fantastic book. Waiting for Normal is by Leslie Connor. So she wrote The Truth is Told by Mason Buttle, which I probably haven't talked about, but I will talk about that one because I love that one too. And I'll Rise for the Honorable Perry T. Cook, I think is his name. All books are amazing by her, all of them. Waiting for Normal is about a girl who is living with her mom. She would like to be living with her dad and her half-sisters in their house and have their perfect family life and their normal home. But for some reason, she is with her mom, and her mom is not the best example of a mom and is not very dependable. So this is another great book about putting yourself in someone else's shoes. And the one that I just finished, Wink, I finished it last night. I couldn't go to sleep till I finished. This one is a pretty new book. I'm pretty sure it's on the Lone Star list this year, but it's about a kid who is in junior high and he just is trying to just be a regular kid, but he finds out he has a very rare eye cancer. And so he has to go through radiation. First, the doctors are telling him like horrible things that he's going to have to do. And they got a second opinion. So he's going through radiation. He's got this goopy gunk that he has to put on his eye all the time. He's losing his hair. People are making fun of him. And in all of that, he finds and discovers that something that he loves that really brings out the best in him. All right, so I hope that you saw something that you liked, some way that you can put yourself in someone else's shoes. Have a great day and go read lots of books.